Hi everyone, and welcome to this short student coffee cup video. I'm Anna, and in this video I'm going to show you the basics of Read and Write for Google Chrome. If you have any questions, please feel free to get in touch using the email address on your screen, and I'll be more than happy to help you out. I'll also put our details up at the end as well. Read and Write is a toolbar that you can use to help with reading, writing, research, and organisation. Today's focus is getting started with Read and Write, specifically using Read and Write for Google Chrome. Read and Write will give you access to a wide range of literacy support tools in one simple toolbar. So today we'll be learning the basics to help you get started. Read and Write sits as a toolbar at the top of your screen and works in connection with the Google Doc that you're working on, or if you're using the Chrome browser as well. So let's take a look at Read and Write for Google Chrome. So you'll find our Read and Write toolbar is an added extension to the Google Chrome toolbar, this little jigsaw puzzle piece. When you open a Google Doc, the toolbar will appear automatically. If it doesn't, click on the Read and Write icon and the toolbar will appear. We've also got this little arrow, which is the discoverability tab that will appear on the Google Chrome toolbar, and it allows you to hide Read and Write when you're not using it. The Read and Write toolbar will appear on the screen just above your Google Doc and will allow you to use the features within Read and Write when working on this document. We've got the three little dots on the right hand side, which will take you to the options to make any changes to any of the features. There's another video which looks at how you can customize the toolbar and looks at the options in a lot more detail. So we're going to start with the play icon to have some of this text read aloud. Simply click in the doc where we want to begin reading, followed by the play icon, and it will read the text aloud.
The concept of motion is described by using terms like velocity, speed, distance, and acceleration.
And just press stop when you're ready to stop reading. So I started the text reading at the beginning of that first sentence, and the software has continuously read through the document until I pressed stop. As well as hearing the text being read, you'll have noticed the dual highlighting colours, which will track the text as it's being read aloud. You can change the voice by clicking into the options menu. You can select a voice from the first drop down. And you'll notice that we also have international voices available that will be able to read any text written in their language. You can adjust the speed of the voice by moving along this slider, right to increase the speed or left to decrease the speed. And you can turn on or off continuous reading. If you turn off continuous reading, then the software will stop reading at a full stop. If you have continuous reading turned on, then it will continuously read through the entire document until you press stop. Then I just press OK to save any changes. The word dictionary provides you with a definition of any terms that you select, so you can quickly look up unfamiliar words within any piece of text. To use the dictionary, highlight a word and then click on the dictionary icon. The dictionary panel will then open up beside your doc. It will tell you if the word is a noun or a verb and so on. And a play icon will appear beside the definition as well. So you can have this read aloud by clicking on the play icon.
Noun. An idea, which is often abstract, the concept of class.
So you can keep this open alongside your doc and look up any words that you need to. The picture dictionary gives you a visual definition of a word. So again, you can highlight a word and then click on the picture dictionary icon, and it will provide a visual representation of any unfamiliar words. Again, you can keep this open alongside your document and continue to look up any words that you need to. You can also insert any of these into the text as a visual reminder. And so you've got a visual link to the keyword. Click the prediction icon, and Read&Write will suggest words while you're typing. Hover your mouse over any of the suggested words in the list to have them read aloud.
Accelerate. Accelerating.
Then you can click on the word to insert it into the document, or you can type it out. You may prefer to use the Talk and Type or Speech Recognition tool to get your ideas down on paper. All you'll need is a headset with a microphone or a laptop with a microphone built in. You can then speak into this and Read&Write will convert that into text. Click on the speech to text icon, and when the microphone appears in a red circle, it is live and recording. So if you're not quite ready, just click on it to make it inactive. When you're ready to start typing, just click on the microphone. Miles per hour. And then you can just close down Talk and Type. You can use the screen mask to apply a screen tint or coloured overlay to your screen. Just click on the icon and a tint will be applied to your screen. You can change the colour of the screen mask to suit your needs, and you can even enter a specific RGB number if you have one. Click on this shortcut to get into the screen masking settings. You can choose from the basic colour palette or enter your RGB number within the advanced colour palette. You can change the opacity of your background as well using this slider. You can also introduce a reading light with an additional colour if you need to. The web search icon is really useful if you're doing some research. Just highlight a word that you'd like to look up, and then click the web search icon to see search results from Google. Read&Write for Google isn't just for Google Docs. You can use it when you're browsing web pages too. Click the Read&Write icon and the web toolbar will appear. You can still use the play icon for text-to-speech, or you can turn on hover speech and hover over any text to read it aloud.
The velocity of an object is the rate of change of its position with respect to a frame of reference and is a function of time.
You can use any of the other tools within the toolbar while browsing the web too. When you are browsing the web, you'll usually be confronted with large amounts of information, images, advertising, and other distractions. The Simplify feature within Read&Write for Google Chrome reduces distractions and clutter to help you focus on the most important content. All of the advertising and other articles have been removed. And you can change the amount and the level of the reading material being displayed as well. You can change the font, the size of the text, the line spacing, and the background colour as well. You can also use the Discover feature to explore new topics and expand your knowledge when reading content on the web. When reading an article, it's common to find yourself opening tab after tab to Google unknown terms found in your text, potentially therefore losing sight of the page and topic that you started with. The Discover feature adds in-context pop-up windows for many terms right within your text. Just click on the purple underlined word or phrase, and you'll get a definition, background information, or sometimes an image as well, to tell you a bit more about that topic. You can even use text-to-speech on the toolbar to have this read aloud.
Archaeology or archaeology. is the study of human activity through the recovery and analysis of material culture.
Thanks for listening. If you have any questions, you can get in touch with me or one of the team using the email address customercare@texthelp.com.